Holy shoot, this skin is cool. What the hell? This skin's so cool. This skin's cool. He's like a freaking beast with a bat. Huh? It's not a shirt, it's his skin. Oh, yeah. It is. Look at his beard. Wait. Eternals is good. Oh my god, he's like a fucking. He's like. Who's that guy? Manila Gorilla or something.
Oh my god.
Wait, I have to Google him.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
Manila Gorilla.
Manila? It's
Magilla. Oh, it is? Oh yeah, Magilla Gorilla. Fuck. He's not as purple. I guess they look kind of similar. I guess the purple story gave it up. I got a gorilla for sale. I got a gorilla for sale. What the heck? His jaw gets so big. Colonel's a beast, dude. Dude, I'm just gonna spam this lane. It doesn't stop till you cancel it. Oh my god. Oh, it's control 3. I'm just gonna spam this if I start winning lane. Wait, what the heck happened? Oh, Caitlyn picked that first blood? Uh-oh. That's not good. Oh. I think Uter might die for some reason. That doesn't look like a good fight. I'm gonna go gain some lane dominance here. I'm gonna start with Q. Wow, they actually won that fight. Uter baited that pretty hard. So that was good. We gave up first blood. But we picked up a redemption kill and we actually secured our blue for Udyr, whereas their jungler had to be chased out. So that was actually an advantageous level 1 for us. Although, the weird thing is, because Malphite got an assist off the first blood, he's going to have a little bit of an above average chime in this lane. At least he didn't get first blood. That would have been worse. Laning against people who get first blood randomly is like the most annoying experience ever. Okay. Damage is not bad. Not bad. At early level 2. Although Trundle's early game isn't that amazing. He does get a lot. He can actually trade really effectively though if you get level 2. Just because of how much power Q gives you, to be honest. I don't think we're going to be ganking top soon anyway. So I'm probably just going to get level 2 of my Q. And maybe look for a trade next time he walks up to see us. The lane's pushing pretty hard into him though. I sort of wasted some damage there. That's my bad. I could drop my ward now. I think Jin's gonna come top very soon. The slow is sort of weird on his Q. It feels kind of awkward. It's not bad though. I don't know, like. They made his Q, the animation scale with attack speed. But it kind of feels weird. I don't know if I like it. I guess it's better late game, but earlier his Q, like, I don't know, it felt a lot more snappy before. How much CS did he miss? Not very much. He did blow like 4 health pots, so he's down to his last one. That's pretty good. If I get ganked, I think I can just run away. Malphite's early game isn't that powerful, and as long as Zinza doesn't have doubles, I should be able to run away with my Frozen Domain. Although it doesn't give me Tenacity anymore, so I have to remember that. I'm very used to just being able to pop my W on Trundle and do whatever I want, but it's not quite the same function as before. What is that, babe? Why'd you send me up here? Don't send me in here. Okay. Zin's recalling top. Can you send it to me somewhere else then? I don't want it here. I just don't. Yeah, I just didn't want it on my stream. Nothing, don't worry. Why? I didn't think you were listening. He's like one hit left. I would have died if I kept chasing though. I needed one more auto attack to kill him. But. Oh well. I'm actually about to hit 6. I might get enough mana for my ult. If I get that. I think I'll just stay. He thought I'd probably back after that wave. I'm just gonna stay just so he misses the wave. Not even because I wanna kill him. Just my presence here made him miss out on like 10 CS. Or even maybe up to 15, I don't know, we'll see. Hang on when he comes back to lane. He's only level 3, he can't kill me. We have boots and Vamp Scepter. Health pot and a ward. That much damage to him. And all I got was Spirit Stone. He doesn't have any additional armor. He's gonna hit 6 really soon. I think his Ignite's still up too. I need to hit the wave to lifesteal somewhere. Those trades weren't really going very well in my favor.
Oh, thank you.
His attack speed still definitely does help him out a lot though. I think I'll be okay. I'll probably manify here. I hate how it's like, I don't know. It was like a legit auto attack reset before, now it's like really slow. I'm gonna hold the lane here. He has ult up. He needs 100 mana to cast it though. So as long as I can make him blow a little bit more on a trade, then I should be safe for most games. It just queued again. He's at barely 100. So even though he has enough for ult, he's not gonna have enough to like follow up on a gank or anything like that if it comes. I just need to stop playing as if it's an auto attack reset. I just realized that. I just need to cast Q and run at him. I keep like running for the auto and then being like, why is my Q going off? And that's because it's not as smooth anymore. You have to run it and just have it pre-casted. I'm just going to push this up here. He's actually completely out of health pots and stuff. He has enough mana for ult though. I really want to dive. Good gank, Cooter. So I was pretty sure that was enough damage to kill him. My ultimate deals 20% of max health, which is pretty significant, especially because Malphite doesn't have much MR yet. And I just tacked on Ignite to that, and it was a healthy chunk of damage. I think I might actually rush Spear the Ancient Golem. Actually, no. I don't think I want to do that. Malphite's going for Spear of the Ancient Golem first, so he's gonna need a lot of health, but he's not actually gonna have much armor yet. What do I wanna do? I got Bilge Water and Ruby Crystal and some health pots and stuff. Don't wanna stack any. I don't really wanna get much attack speed against Malphite just because he's so innately good against champions that stack it. But if I can upgrade to a blade legitimately after like, my next stack or whatever, then I might look to pick that up. You just worded it. No big deal. Oh, I picked up emblem. Interesting. Didn't expect that. Oops, I accidentally queued a creep. So his ult up. He flashed my flash. He could just ulted away, I think. He would actually win that trade. I thought I had enough burst to kill him, but I was wrong. I did, however, drive him out of lane, so that is not the worst thing that could have happened. I probably should have just held onto my flash there, because I could have just pushed up to his turn and dove him. I don't think he would have expected that. Wow, my ult's on such a low cooldown. This flat 20% of his max health. It's actually pretty damn good. The fact that I steal it is even more like, is more awesome. I'm gonna push this up and back. Pretty low on mana. Trying to see if he would ult me under turret, but I don't think he's got the guts. He's not back here. Alright, let's get a Kindle Jump for the CDR. And throw out my W, max range of it, and run back top. He assumed himself pushing, so he's gonna back too. I actually doubled his CS basically, so that's pretty significant. That's already a huge advantage, not to mention the kill I picked up. Run back top, and just get this pushed out. By the way, my Q gives me 40 bonus attack damage if I activate on any target, including a creep, which is pretty obnoxious. And it lasts for 8 seconds, and it's only on like a 4 second cooldown with no CDR at max rank, which is pretty damn ridiculous. So basically, Trundle will always have that AD bonus as long as you're using your abilities correctly. I wonder if I can fight this. He's gonna try to ult me back. Fudge. I think if I save my drain for when the ignite tick was. When it finished, when the ignite stopped ticking, I actually might have been able to turn that. I saw the ignite up, and Malphite lived. He had like 400 health. That would have been like one more Q plus my ignite, that would have killed him. But I didn't have enough time because I was too low. I think I should have just let the ignite tick out and then pop my ult. I was really worried though because I thought I was going to get burst even before I'd have enough time to wait for that. That's why I kind of got scared and used it anyway. Run back top. I could have went for Zen. Let's check his health. What? Yeah, that's why I said it was a server. Neil. What the heck? He's chasing with red buff. Maybe I'll have to pick this up. And he's stuck. No, he got the he got the proc off. I was like, heh heh heh. Their blue might be up. It is. Kinda want that. Could probably smite it. Yeah, there you go. If Riven face track, actually Riven's 2-0. I was gonna say Riven face track mega, probably blow him up, but he's pretty strong. I don't think they'd be that easy actually. Malphite stacking health. His ult up. They're both moving on me. Sid had mo boots, but he just backed off. I'm gonna back off too. I have Blazing King and 100 gold or so. I'm gonna stay top till I get it. Cause I think his Malphite's not, he's like not really stacking armor. He got a little bit, but like I said, he was stacking health. So that's something you get against him, and it's just gonna make me stronger in general. Trono's a really good duelist. I push sound back. And Malphite's not so reliant on his attack damage, even though he gets a lot of damage off through his auto attacks. But against another champion, such as like Riven, Zinn, or Caitlyn, using my Chomp on an enemy is a lot more crippling because it takes away half the AD it steals, which at rank 5, it's 40. So basically you just steal 20 AD and you gain 40. So that's a net 60 AD increase during trades. So for example, top lane, level 9, Trundle versus level 9 Riven, you basically have 60 AD net over him, which is pretty huge just from one ability. And of course you have to factor in like other stuff such as their kit strength. And every champions are only as strong as they are as a whole, not by one. They're not defined by a single ability, but in isolation, that's a pretty cool thing to think about. So I'm maxing Q and then W, just because I like the per point increase on W. And since I rush Blazer and King, the attack speed is going to help me scale really effectively. Oh my god, I got creep blocked there. Oh, they're ganking me. They backed off. I think if they ganked me, I'd still go for Malphite. Feels like his Q's almost like a slight interrupt. I'm probably 2v1. Hey. Well, it's good though. I might be dead. Oh my god, I dodged it. Or I didn't dodge it. Did I hit the charm there? I think the charm saved me. I'm not sure, but that was really close. I was confident in my ability to win that 2v1, but taking like turn turret shots and diving Malphite was a little bit more than I asked for. Ooh, he's really low. I'm gonna get Spear of the Ancient Golem here, and probably just Zerker's Greaves, to be honest. I don't need anything else, and I already have Tenacity from the Spirit. Thank you. gonna take red. And push top endlessly with it. They can't really do anything to me. I'm just really, really strong right now. If I get on Malphite, I'd kill him too. He still hasn't picked up any armor. Rampage. Poor fool. He has ult though, actually. He might be able to just ult away. And troll his way up. Attack moving into the brush. He went back. Thought he might be recalling on the spot that he finished the creep wave off in, but he just went all the way back to base. Pretty safe approach. Oh, that blue just spawned. I'm gonna go take that. Pushing this up. Trundle with Spear of the Ancient One plus Wither King melts buffs like blue. So I like two shot it. Aw, what the heck? I was so strong right now, I wanted to fight. Oh well. I guess I'll just take that win. Clean sweep.